I was wondering if you could take my mum to dinner.
Hi, I'm Jack Savoretti, and I'm about to answer some questions from our Mini Magic listeners.
Hi, Jack. My name's Chloe Wright, and my question for you is, what gives you more pleasure, writing songs or singing songs?
Wow, that's a good question. I wish I got more questions like that during press meetings. They're two completely different feelings. Because writing a song, I always feel like you're finding something. I never feel like I'm actually writing a song. I always feel like I've kind of landed upon something. It's a bit like looking for treasure. So I sort of feel like I've just found something that's been dug away somewhere. When I sing it, I feel like I'm showing it to everybody else, whatever it is that I discovered. So they're two complete different feelings. One is a feeling of discovery, and the other one is like, look at what I found.
Hi Jack, it's Hugo, and I'd like to know what your favourite film is. And do you like playing Minecraft like me? Bye!
I haven't gotten into Minecraft yet, Hugo. My son, on the other hand, hasn't been allowed to get into it just yet, but is doing everything he can in his power to kind of persuade me. I think he's manipulating me, but I'm going to use the word persuasion to give him the benefit of the doubt. Into getting involved. My favorite film, this is a tough one, but I'm going to say one that I think you should watch, you can watch. It's called The Goonies. The Goonies was one of Steven Spielberg's first film, and it's about kind of before I was talking about how songwriting is like finding treasure. Well, this is a group of kids that they're getting their house sold because their parents don't have enough money, but in the attic, they find a treasure map to a pirate's treasure, One-Eyed Willie's lost pirate treasure. So they go on this crazy adventure where there's booby traps and all these kind of things to find this pirate ship, which has the treasure that will save their home. So I highly recommend it. It's one of the best movies in the world and probably still my number one, still to this day.
Hi, Jack. What do your children think about you being a pop star?
Hi, Tommy and Lila. My children don't think I'm a pop star. I couldn't be further from that to them. They kind of always say to me, are you singing again, Papa? Are you playing piano again, Papa? But jokes apart, they both kind of are obsessed about music as well. So that's really cool. My daughter, I mean, she started helping me write songs. Sometimes I'll be sat here at the piano with a guitar and I'll get stuck on something. And I'll say to her, just sing something. What do you think works here? And she completely freestyles and improvises. So she's a wonderful songwriter already. And my son is very good on the drums. He's becoming very, very good on the drums. So I think a part of them loves it and a part of them gets a little bit embarrassed by it. If they hear me on radio or if they see something in a magazine, they kind of cringe. But otherwise, I think they like my music. So we're good for now.
I was wondering if you could take my mum to dinner.
I would love to take your mom to dinner. What am I talking about? I would absolutely love to take your mom to dinner. I'm sure I'll cook. That'll probably be the best. I'd love to cook your mom dinner. So fingers crossed, sometime soon, hopefully.
Hi, Jack, it's Hugo, and I'd like to know what your favorite food is. Bye.
My favorite food. Well, I'm a little bit biased. In case my name hasn't given it away, I have Italian heritage. So pretty much most Italian food. This is going to sound really strange to you, Hugo. I don't know if you've had this before, but my favorite dish in the world is an octopus salad, which is octopus and potatoes, followed by a lasagna al pesto, which is something very Genovese, which is where I'm from. So if you ever go to Genoa, or if you ever go anywhere near there, I highly recommend you have the octopus salad and the pesto lasagna.
Go.
My mommy thinks you're handsome. Do you get a little attention from the mummy that the school gates?
My favorite part about this question, but also a little bit worrying, is I think your dad is filming because I heard a man's voice say go just before you said my mom thinks you're handsome. So now I'm starting to feel a bit nervous that I'm ever going to run into your dad. Thank you is all I can say. I guess I'm just going to say thank you for that. Yeah, so that's very flattering. But again, Dad, I hope we're cool.
Have you missed not being able to play any concerts?
I have missed not playing concerts. I've missed it more than I actually even could have imagined. I think the thing I miss about it the most is connecting with a room filled of people that you don't know. You don't necessarily speak the same language. You don't necessarily have the same sort of ideas. But in that moment, music has this amazing ability to make, as I always kind of say it, a room full of strangers become friends just for that moment. You hope that it lasts and you take it with you when you leave the show. But the power, the magic that you feel from hearing music live, from playing music to people and feeling them react to it, it's absolute, it's golden, it's magic. And I miss that a lot. And I hope that we'll be able to do it very soon. And I hope that you guys come to a show. Well, that's been me, Jack Savoretti. Thank you so much to all you amazing Mini Magic listeners for your awesome questions. Some of the best questions I've been answering for a long time. So really refreshing. And I can't wait to see you guys all very soon on the road. Take it easy. Bye-bye.